This is a banjo frog.
A very common frog species in the city of Melton.
Often you hear them croaking at night time, going bonk, 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 bonk. And you could be excused to think that you have a bluesgrass band playing in your backyard. Bonk, 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 bonk. They're called a banjo frog because they sound like a banjo. The other name for a banjo frog is a pobblebonk frog. And of course, frogs belong to the class Amphibia.
And like a tree frog, banjo frogs have digging feet for burrowing beneath the soil.
Oh, check out his large eyes. He's nocturnal in nature and comes out at nighttime. They have a glandular skin.
Their glandular skin absorbs oxygen and moisture,
which they can drink through
like a sponge.
And that's why they're so highly susceptible to human beings' pollution. Look at his eyes. They're sticking out of the surface of the soil, looking around for potential prey and predators. Because of their squat, fat, dumpy body, banjo frogs often get confused for toads in people's back gardens. But they're not a toad. They don't have warty skin, and we don't have any naturally occurring toads
in the city of Melton.
Frogs eat up all the bugs. He'd be easy prey for a kookaburra or an egret. His coloration helps him to hide in his subterranean world, often found in people's back gardens, even in sandpits at kindergartens and in primary schools. They can survive the desiccating dryness of a drought wrapped up in their mucous membrane. How about that? That's an incredible adaptation. I reckon they're amazing. So be careful. Don't pollute. Amphibians are highly susceptible to pollution. Make sure in your household you use biodegradable detergents. And be careful
what you wash down our drains in the city of Melton.
Oil, detergents, paints and other chemicals that go down our local drains end up in our waterways and wetlands where our frogs live. Hey, wash your car on your lawn. And don't pour chemicals or paint down the drain.
If you'd like to help protect banjo frogs in the city of Melton,
make sure your cat isn't gobbling up your frogs. Don't use pesticides and herbicides in your back garden, because frogs were here first. And let's help out frogs together. And why not this weekend create a frog bog in your back garden and invite frogs to call your home their home. Bonk, 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 bonk.